Hi everyone, I'm Nathaniel. Welcome to another episode of The Body Maths. So very quickly, if you're not subscribed yet, make sure you do that, turn on post notifications, because we'll be solving very important questions today. Limits, they are really, really common in the past questions. So let's get started. So look at this question now. First of all, f of x is equal to this. This is a very, very simple question. But the reason why people run away from limits, or they get it wrong, or they don't know what method to use, is because they don't understand the process. So there are different, there are about four strategies for finding limits. They are very easy. This is just basic limits, and I will explain everything to you. They are very, very examinable. So it says, find the limits of f of x, which is this function here, as x tends towards 2. So this means x tends towards 2. So let's say as x tends towards 20. I'll explain. This is has a hole there. That's totally fine. So like this and like this. So let's assume the value here is, let's say, 3, for example. Let's just assume. So what this is saying is that as x tends towards 20, so if this is the x-axis and this is the y, so what they're asking you is that, what is the limit, what is that range of x is the domain. Now you see the reason why we did domain first. X is the domain. Now so if the independent values of x keeps changing from the left or from the right, so this is the left, so it's coming, it's like the right, but it's coming from the left to the right, so it's coming from negative and it's going, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, and if x keeps tending towards 20 from the left or from the right, let's say from 100, 50, 30, 21, if it keeps moving towards 20 from the left or from the right, what is happening to 3? So 3 will be reacting in a specific way. So that's what they're asking you, what is the limit, what is the reaction you will get as x tends towards 20. It's kind of like a car, a moving vehicle moving to 20. So if it keeps moving, you will see, you will notice that the graph will keep moving up or down or whatever, but it will keep moving. And but then what will happen to the value of y in relation to the x movement? So that's what they are telling you, what is the reaction of y as x tends towards 20, to the left or to the right of x. So that's just it. No one will ask you for this, they will only ask you to solve. So let's do that. Now to find the limits, now all you need to do, there are different methods, but this one now you can just directly substitute. So if you try substituting and it goes, then fine, you don't have to do anything else. So as x tending towards 20 is as easy as direct substitution. So what is x? Like I said, remember the graph we plotted. So anytime you put 20 here, you ought to get y. So this is y. So y is equal to, which is f of x, 20 square plus 1, for example. So y will be equal to what? 401, so 401, for example. But realistically, the question says 2, so as x tending towards 2. So just directly substitute and you get f of x, you get the function here, so the limit. So the limit, you can do this, the limit of x, the limit of this function here as x tends towards 2, this is the implication, this is the, you can write it this way, it makes sense this way. So the limit of f of x, you can put this here, as x tends towards 2 is, so just put this here, 2 raised to the power 2 plus 1, that will be equal to 4 plus 1, and that will be equal to 5. So the limit is 5. So as x tends towards 2, y will react this way towards 5. It will be changing, maybe like 4.9, 4.99, 4.8, all that. So that's what it means. So you can see how easy this first question is. Now this first question is very easy. All we needed to do was just directly substitute. There will be cases where direct substitution would not work. So you have to use other methods, maybe like factorize a little bit, expand a little bit before substituting. So let's proceed. So now this question is asking, what is the limit of the function as x tends towards 1? So you can just direct substitute, right? So that's the first method. So the limit of f of x, like this, as x tends towards 1. So what is the value of y? That's basically what you're asking. So just direct substitute, that will be 1 square minus 1. I can see this is not even possible. So you can see that the answer for this is now 0/0. This is not possible. Every time you get the denominator 0 or 0/0, even more troublesome, anytime the denominator is 0, is equal to 0, then you are not solved yet. The answer is not correct. It's indefinite, or you can say does not exist. So every time you are solving, you directly substitute and you are getting the limit, the denominator as 0, it is wrong. It is not correct. That's not the limit. It's undefined and it does not exist. So you can write it there, but it doesn't stop there. Let us try using let us break it down first, because there's some kind of problem with it. We can't just directly substitute. So if you get 0/0, this will be wrong. That's not the answer. They want you to break it down first before substituting. So let us break this fraction down first before directly substituting. So to do that, using a difference of two squares, the numerator here is x squared minus 1. And x squared minus 1 is still the same thing as x squared minus 1 squared, like this. So like this, minus 1 squared. So the difference of two squared, this expression is the same thing as x minus 1. So this is a numerator now. See, I expanded it like this, and then divided by the denominator x minus 1, like this. So I can cancel this out now, right? So this can cancel out to this. So you can see that the reason why it wasn't working was because this x minus 1 was in the way. So we needed to like cancel out, to remove it out. So now we remove this problematic denominator, and then we're left with just x plus 1. So now we can find the limit of the function now. So now we have just x plus 1. So f of x is equal to x plus 1 here. So as x tending towards 1, right? So the limit of f of x, or you can put this x plus 1, like the limit of f of x, if you don't want to put f of x, you can put this one, as x tends towards 1 is equal to, put 1 anyway you see x, put 1, so 1 plus 1, like this. So the answer is simply 2. That's the correct answer, not over 0. So anytime you see when you directly substitute and you are getting 0, that's not the answer. You need to expand first, or factorize, or break it down to and expand it more before you directly substitute. So that is the second method. So let's try another one. So this is the question. We have this limit here, the limit f of x as x tends towards 1. So what is x tends towards 1? So if you directly substitute, like put 1 here, this would be wrong, right? So you can't use direct substitution method here. So let's try, let's factorize, let's do like manipulate and see what you can do to cancel out. And if you do that, like there's nothing else you can do here. We can't factorize, we can't break down, we can't there's nothing else we can do. We can't manipulate the expression again, so we can do something else. So it means that this the limit as x tends towards 1 for this equation here, this function here, does not exist. But then you have to prove why it is undefined first. You need to write, put this down and say it's undefined. Very simple. So you might see a question like this, the same thing. So what is the limit of this function as x tends towards 1? So you can try the first one, you can directly substitute, but I can see here that if I directly substitute here, the denominator will be equal to 0, And what did you say if the denominator is equal to 0? If the denominator is equal to 0, it is undefined. It is indefinite. It does not exist. So this is not the limit. And we are doing direct substitution here. So meaning direct substitution is not the way. We need to expand or carry out some other method that we can find to using algebra, just manipulate it a little bit. So something can cancel out and then we can now substitute. That's when we can get the limit. So basically all we need to do is just keep trying. But from the numerator here, I can expand the numerator. So like this, difference of two cubes, like this. So what's the difference of two cubes for this? You can memorize this, memorize the difference of two squares, memorize the difference of two cubes, because you will need all these things. So anytime you see this expression like this, because this is still the same thing, so I can expand this as like this. So anytime you see this expression here, it is still the same as this. So you can see now that the numerator is the same thing as this and the denominator is this. So we can cancel out these problematic expressions here, and then we're just left with this. So all we need to do now is substitute. Now we can now directly substitute because it makes sense now. So if you do that, you get, so if you do that now, you get 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 3. So this is the correct limit, the correct value of y. So as x tends towards 1 in this expression here, the y value will react this way towards 3.